Ladies and gentlemen, I am Arafat, representing GEMS4 project. As you can probably see in the brochure, my team leader Christopher was supposed to come and make this presentation, but due to some unavoidable circumstances, he couldn't make it today. So he sends his regard for this. And before I get into my presentation, I would like to formally thank old friend Emmanuel and Mobile Money Africa team for giving us this opportunity to come and make this presentation here in this conference and share our efforts in the space of mobile money in Nigeria. The content of my presentation is, I will briefly talk about the project that I represent. Then we will talk about the opportunity that lies for mobile money service providers in the aspect of wholesale and retail trading. We will also talk about the challenges that we have identified in harnessing this potential opportunity, and briefly talk about how we are trying to work with different partners within the mobile money ecosystem of Nigeria. And I will end my presentation with introducing the challenge fund that we have in our project. As you can see, we are basically a project of British government, that's DFID, and the name of the project is Growth and Employment in States for Wholesale and Retail Industry. And this is a project which is being implemented by COFE International Development. The basic purpose of this project was to work with the wholesale and retail industry of Nigeria so that this specific industry can have inclusive growth and efficiency. And let me give you a bit of background, about the reason for conceiving this project on the part of DFID and federal government of Nigeria. If you look at the macro economy of Nigeria, something around 24% of GDP is attributed by wholesale and retail. And for an oil-rich country like Nigeria, it's huge. And if you look at the employment scenario, something around 24% is attributed by wholesale and retail. So that's why we thought if we can bring in efficiency within this sector, it will probably have some kind of positive implication on the macroeconomy and private sector development of the country. And with that vision, we started engaging with the actors of wholesale and retail industry of Nigeria in order to understand how do they do their business, what are the challenges they're facing, and we kind of came up with some interventions from our project end. And during this engagement, we observed the kind of challenges these wholesale retail actors are facing in terms of making payments. I will give you specific examples. Like I was talking to traders up north in Kano and Kaduna, where they have told me that they need to commute 150 kilometers for accessing the nearest bank branch. And this is something they have to do on a daily basis for making shipment of the producers to Lagos or to Port Harcourt and other trading locations. I have also came across instances where traders have said, and have seen actually, that they're literally carrying bags of cash on a truck for making payments to their trading partners in different trading locations. So that's the kind of reality that we are dealing with. And from our project, we thought if we can provide access to easier payment solution to these traders, then it will probably have a positive implication on their margin, thereby the total income for these traders. Talking about opportunity for mobile money industry, as you can see, roughly around 10 million traders are doing transaction in this wholesale and retail space of Nigeria. And predominantly, they're doing their business in cash. And as I said, 18% of the GDP predominantly is passing through this cash transaction, which is completely out of the formal financial system. Another good opportunity is traders are very easy to locate geographically because they're doing their trading in specific trading locations and they're very closely knitted. So if any interested mobile money service providers is interested to service this segment, all they have to do is they have to go and approach these trading locations. Another easy opportunity for mobile money industry is it's very easy to follow the money, because if you follow the producers, like if you follow where tomato is being produced and where it is being consumed, you can easily trail the money, and thereby you can offer services to them. From regulatory perspective, these kind of traders are much easier to track because they are doing their trading in specific locations, and they are not like normal end user whom you cannot easily trace if there is any issue regarding anti-money laundering or terrorist funding or something like that. And most importantly, as I said, most of these people are out of formal financial system. So by offering mobile money service to this kind of people, the mobile money service providers will be exposed to the financial behavior of this trader, which would enable the mobile financial service providers to come up with product which are tailored to the need of this kind of customer. And last but not the least, we believe the pain point for using cash is severe in Nigeria. And from the global experiences, the use case for mobile money is very tangible. So that's why from our project, we decided that we would try to work with the different mobile money service providers, super agents, to offer mobile money service to this kind of traders. In doing so, we came across 7-8 major challenges, which most of it was discussed by different previous speakers. But I will just talk about these on the perspective of wholesale and retail. Inadequate agent network, this has been talked about, but just to give you an example, there is this trading location here in Lagos called Mile 12, and it is home to something around 15 to 16,000 traders who are doing trading on a daily basis. And while we were engaging with these traders, we hadn't seen a single agent who is servicing these 15 or 16,000 traders. Lower geographic coverage of agency network is basically the thing where just by deploying agent in Mile 12 will not help adoption of mobile money, because the traders who are doing trading in Mile 12, they will have to make payments to their trading partners in trading locations, maybe in Kano or Kaduna. So as long as this entire trading corridor is not covered, adoption of mobile money will not happen for this sector. We have also observed skills gap on the part of mobile money service providers, super agents, agents, as well as end consumers. And by skills gap, what I mean is basically, if you look at the existing model that are being used nowadays here in Nigeria, it's primarily technology-based. It doesn't cover the issues of liquidity management, accounts keeping, bookkeeping, basic level promotion, and so on and so forth. We have also heard about the unreliable mobile technology network, so I'm going to skip that. Cultural barrier has also been discussed. People in Nigeria seem to like to feel their cash. They seem to not to buy into this idea of e-value and so on and so forth. And there is also this issue of regulatory issue. By regulatory issue, what we mean is, if you look at the existing KYC level for mobile money, it nohow meets the requirement of the traders of wholesale and retail. From our research, we have seen that average payment size for the traders in wholesale and retail is something around 260,000. And with the highest level of KYC, this trader probably will have to make three attempts for making this one single payment. And this is just not efficient, and this is not something they probably be willing to do. How we are trying to work with this, we have basically divided all our activities into three work stream. First thing is creating a conducive regulatory environment where we are trying to engage with Central Bank of Nigeria. And we are trying to link Central Bank of Nigeria with these traders who are operating their business in very traditional markets, so that CBN gets to know what are the exact requirements, and accordingly Central Bank of Nigeria can revise or re-engineer the policy framework for quick adoption by them. We are also working with mobile money service providers, super agents for deployment of agent. We have done profiling of major trading locations across Kano, Kaduna, and Lagos. And we are working with them. We are bringing in international consultant for developing local capacity of these partners for continuously recruiting and developing skills of this agent for seamlessly servicing these people. Last but not the least, awareness and promotion, as I said, had been a big issue. While we were engaging with all these traders in wholesale and retail, I probably talked to more than 1,000 traders, and out of them, just one reported that he has heard about mobile money service and he has used it. There had been a couple of others who have heard about it, but they didn't have any clue about where is the agent, how can he avail it, or all these things. So these are pretty much the things we are trying to do. In addition to these activities, I would also like to introduce a challenge fund component that we have in our project. We have roughly around 3.5 million pounds private sector development fund, which we intend to use for development of mobile money ecosystem in Nigeria. And we will be granting this award based on competitive application process. It has certain prerequisites, like the applicant will have to contribute 50% of it, and another 50% of that 50% has to be in cash, and so on and so forth. And the areas that I think will be relevant for the participants in this conference would be business productivity, product and service development, and increasing access to finance. And if anyone among you have any query or question regarding this challenge fund, please take a note of the email address I have stated here, which is mmfund@kofi.com. With this, I would like to conclude my presentation. Thank you very much.